down enough across the just kick it around. No eggs from them today. But from her, I definitely know that there are no eggs from the female cockerels. So, let's check the hens in the main barn. They're getting used to it because it's mucking out time, nearly. So, we take a look and I think we can give them a look at later. Four hens, big hens, and I bought seven chicks. Now the seven chicks are doing well. They've also got lots of wind up hen. I'm sure yet, I've got six or eight. Yeah, I've bought when the First World War started out, they kind of went away, and then when the Second World War, and then after the First World War, they came back. It was nice, but they only had a certain amount of stuff. And during the Second World War, they went extinct again. Now they've come back. I've got two. I've got a male and a female. The female and the girl at the moment seem to be going a bit bizarre. I could do with another bag up here. Chicken drinker. And every time I used to come up here, it used to be empty. So every day I was filling it up 2-3 times a day. Because I've just moved some more birds out of here, it's slowing down, but I thought I'd rather buy this pet in here so I don't have to refill it daily, and it keeps it nice and fresh and whatsoever, and the girls can always drink from it whenever they want. chickens and more of a better life rather than just sitting in a cage all day, just letting them eat. You know, bird food's around at the moment, so I can't get these guys out. Every Saturday they get broccoli or cauliflower or whatever. They always get every chicken I own gets a muck out every Saturday. There's a fresh bed, a fresh play area, especially with the girls. My roof is quite bad at the moment. I need to get it fixed. It's dripping a bit of water every time it rains. So every Tuesday and every Thursday they get scraped out with just a normal broom. The front area without around here that gets brushed out, because when it rains, but if it does rain, it turns into like slurry, and I don't want that in my chicken pen. Now, moving on to the French cockerel and the French hen. I've also got some mixed breeds in here. They vary from the battery hens to Spanish birds to Chesterfields to some other birds. And I've got a Brahma, or whatever you say. She is getting big. She's not even 1 year old yet. So, yeah, I mean, from what I had 2 years ago, I had four hens I rescued. And I rescued them from a place, and the woman I rescued them from said that the rest of their friends got eaten by a fox. It was a rescue place, it was a really nice rescue place. Got eaten by a fox, and them four was the only ones. So I rehomed them into my own place. Took them to the fields, where the chicken coop they're staying in. Normally chickens don't lay eggs for the next 21 days, or they need to get settled in first. Some chickens take longer than others. But the first hour after I got them, I went up to the land and they seemed to have laid 3 eggs out of 4 chickens on the first day, which was bad. And then a couple of weeks later, one of my sheep got into the chicken pen and cut his horn. One of my weapons. He cut his horn, and the fox got into the cage. Although they got shut away, this was in the middle of winter. Every time, every day, they got out about 9 o'clock and they got put away about 4:30. When it was getting closer to spring, they was going to start coming out a bit later, well, earlier, and then getting shut away later. But, the fox got them four, and then I haven't had no chickens for 2 years basically, and then back in June during the first lockdown I decided I'd get some more chickens. And then I had them, and the first day I had 3 eggs out of 5 chickens, wasn't bad, and then I lost one due to being ill and it had no feathers. And then I walked through the door with 11 more chickens. And yeah, I don't know how to express it really. I'm really grateful, and I'm enjoying this with my chickens and the sheep. I'm enjoying it so dearly. I'll give you a little. It's going to be to do with chickens. That's all I'm going to give you. So, let's get on and feed these chickens, eh? We can take the wheelbarrow, tip it, and then later on I can put another bag up. Two cockerels in the pen over there and the two in the barn. They've got food. Now, you may be wondering, is this guy crazy? Not some chicken slaughter in here, but you might have seen it earlier. Let's just shut that. The chicken's water is actually there. Because when I chum away every night, that's like every chicken I've got. Every chicken, well, every animal I have, every single day, I'm out here. Or if I'm not out here, I'm always out in the afternoon. Every single animal I have that's fresh, clean water, every single day. That goes from chickens to horses to sheep to dogs to cats to chicks to anything really. But yeah, it's a bit, I'm struggling at the moment because I haven't really got that much space for chickens. I'm looking to find a bigger system for more chickens. A bigger system for more chickens so I've got more space. I've got another coop, but that won't really do much. There's two small bushes that can go in there. There's plenty of room for them to, but for like Rahima or Rahama or whatever you say, or the other hens or the cockerels, that's not that much space. But I'm looking to build a bigger cage. So I can have more chickens, I can have more eggs. Trust me, chickens, eggs that I get every day, I have them almost every single day. They taste absolutely wicked. They taste amazing. So gorgeous that I haven't bought eggs from the supermarket in just over almost a year. Many of you might be asking how many eggs I get daily. Well, small hen out of the French lot, she's started just laying, so I'm getting one egg per day, but I am getting one from her today. I've got four coming out the big hens in the barn. Mate, sometimes I get a fifth one out of the Spanish bird. And then obviously these don't lay eggs, the bluebells or the boys in the barn, but so yeah, about six eggs a day, if I'm lucky, four. Four eggs a day, or maybe five eggs a day. But yeah, like to do it, but I know the chickens aren't out and all of that, but soon it's going to be spring and summer, so there's no point. I might try it next year, and plus, because the chickens aren't out, they're not really that much missing, so it sounds like a good idea, but it sounds like it's not the best of hygienic rates, basically. I might try it with some other ones, some other jigs.